Hello and welcome. I'm Goldie Gaming and this is a nice little moment for my channel as this is my first upload of a Civ 6 game. I've got an upload or two of Civilization games from Civ 5. Civ 5 is the Civ I've probably spent the most time on, although I have been playing the game since Civ 1. I've always loved the Civ games. I think they are brilliant strategy games. So what I'm going to be doing here is I could spend quite a while just going over all of the different leaders and such, although I think that would begin to take far too long. So I'm just going to go quickly into advanced setup here. We're going to do a basic Pangaea map with standard size, so we get 8 leaders. I don't like any less than 8 leaders. I think it gets a bit lacking, really. And we're just going to go ahead and have a look at John Cupton. There he's there. This is one of the DLC packs that came out for the game. It's the only one I own. The others you can get at the moment are, there's a Persia, an Alexander, and Poland, I believe. Those are something I'll be looking to pick up in the future. I'll probably do playthroughs of those as well if anyone's interested. But what we're getting here from John Cutton is the main thing for me. The benefits they get to their districts. Sorry. Districts are probably for me the biggest change in Civ 6 from Civ 5. It gives you a lot more to think about in your overall city placements and such.
From the first stirrings of life beneath water to the great beasts of the Stone Age.
So what else have we got here as Australians?
First upright steps have come far.
I should probably wait for Sean Bean to shut up first.
From this early cradle of civilization on towards the stars. Prime Minister Curtin, you will lead Australia through challenge after challenge, and your people will emerge all the stronger for it. Others will seek friendship for your strength. If these friends prove loyal, your might and protection will carry you far. But stay vigilant, for aggression is not your natural course.
That's him done. Right, so just a quick mention here, this is a slightly modded game, although there's no actual mods to the gameplay as such. That's only little quality of life changes and such, but I'll link any and all mods that I'm currently using in the description. With that said, we'll have a look now at what the Australian Empire offers us. Australians are, this is the first time they've ever appeared in a Civ, in Civ 6 here. So that's one of the reasons why I like the idea of playing as them. So you get 100% production bonus, which is massive. Anytime you either liberate a city-state, or if you get a declaration of war against you. Getting a declaration of war against you can be quite tricky. When you're playing on more difficult difficulty levels, you're pretty much guaranteed that it's going to happen lots, and it's going to happen early. So you're going to have that production bonus quite often, I would imagine. In terms of liberating the city states, that's quite a difficult one as well. What we also get bonuses to housing, which is another major change to Civ 6 or Civ 5. I'll explain that as the game's going on. You get bonuses to housing from coastal cities, which means you're not overly tied to having to settle on river adjacent tiles. Pastures will trigger a culture bomb, and that does give you every surrounding tile, although I haven't ever tested it to see if you can pick up tiles from an AI using it. I actually presume that it wouldn't allow you to do that. Your yields from campus districts, commercial hubs, holy sites, and theatres all get plus ones from charming appeal and plus three from breathtaking appeals. That's actually been gimped. When this Civ first came out, it was plus two and plus four, and it was just considered much too strong. But even as it is, it's still really good. It's going to give you a benefit to pretty much any playstyle, whether you want the gold, the science, the religion, or the culture. We get a unique, tile improvement, known as the Outback Station. They give us plus one food and plus one production for each adjacent pasture. No, sorry. They give us plus one food and plus one production as a base. They give you plus one food for each adjacent pasture. That's tying in, as you can see, with the culture bomb. And also, as you advance through the eras, they get better. You get a unique unit. I can't remember what it's a replacement for. It replaces infantry. It's plus 10 combat strength on coastal tiles, which, as you can see from the housing on coastal tiles, they would benefit like an island map or such. And plus 5 when in neutral or foreign territory, so basically outside of your own territory, they are even stronger. If you can trigger the plus 5 and the plus 10 at the same time, you have yourselves a shitheart, you know? So that's a lot of unique stuff going on here for this nation. Let's see where we start off. Let's see what we've been given. First off, a ton off the grid and a ton on the yields. So we've been given tobacco by the looks of it as our main luxury resource, which I'm actually relatively unhappy with. I think it's one of the weaker ones, although I guess if we want to chase an early religion, it could be useful. Give me a second, guys. I'm just going to turn down some of that audio. There we go. That should be better. Right. So I've got Starting Scout and Starting Builder on as mods, which is, I forgot I actually do have some gameplay mods. What we could test here is whether we can get adjacency bonuses from the river and the coastal tile counted in for, housing bonuses, or whether you just get one or the other. We have deer here, not too good. Another deer there. Again, it's not great. We got a couple of culture bonds we could use up here. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Both of them are within our borders, although most of the tiles that we're getting the culture bomb won't be unless we settle a second city. I would like to settle on that hill, although it's going to move me away from the coast. I could get a peach of a harbour here, especially if I settle over there, but it's going to take me a couple of turns to get to in order to plant the city. I really do like to settle coastally because the adjacent bonuses you get to the harbour district is massive. Take the time and actually do that. Why not? Want to still get both of these. I'm losing that, but I'll probably end up with a secondary city over here. We'll see how that goes. Normally I would just settle in place. I don't like wasting time before putting my city down. I didn't mean to do that at all. He's picked up bronze working straight away. That is awesome. Picking up the bronze working. Eureka for bronze working, at least I think it was. Yeah, because kill free barbarians. Sometimes I prefer to try and ignore barbarians entirely. Right, so here we go. We have our first city. We have Canberra. I'm going to go ahead and Canberra. That can be cranberry. Apologies to any Australians or anyone even from Canberra. Right, so what do we want in this little city to start us off? Since we have our starting scout, that's not too much of a worry. One of the reasons I like the idea of doing the starting scout and builder is it allows you to build that monument right off the bat. And sailing will be brilliant for us to be able to hook these things up. We also just got the Eureka from it for settling coastally, so we'll pick that up. He can't even swim yet because we don't have the sailing. Give ourselves a little farm. What we've also done by moving our city here is actually given ourselves some pretty crappy initial yields. We have a shit lot of hills though. It's going to be a high production city. And let's just continue scouting with our little guy. We've got more pastures here. We could another one with a lot more hills again. You can see us having a couple of decent cities out of this starting location. It's an extra luxury for us as well over there. Yeah, we don't have lumber mills, or I don't even think we have the ability to build mines yet. Yeah, we need mining first. So this builder right now is actually pretty useless. We have found ourselves a natural wonder, giving us the Eureka for astrology. That's very nice indeed. We got has a promotion that we should have given him. We just had Barb pop here, which is quite nice that we actually moved away. It gives us a little bit more distance and they won't become as annoying as quickly. Although we all know how frustrating the fucking Barbs are. And in fact, if you're not entirely too used to Civ 6 at all yet, I'd say Barbarians are actually more annoying in this than they were in Civ 5. Especially if they have nearby horses, which these guys fucking do. Shit, I'm going to take them out quite early. Because they just start spamming you with horsemen. Given a reasonable start, it looks, especially in terms of nearby pastures. Maybe quite nice for me to get the pantheon belief. It gives culture from pastures. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can only see 5, 6. I can see 7 already. And that's just going to be within my initial sort of couple of cities. Might even end up better than that. I'm thinking that's going to be a strong choice. An ivory down here. Our city, unfortunately, is just short of it with its 3 tile reach. And we found ourselves a relic. Lovely jubbly. So that's giving us 4 faith off the bat, which is great. It means we are pretty much guaranteed a relatively early pantheon. I'm going to go ahead and queue up mining right now. Definitely want to be able to get some mines in here for extra production. Starts getting this guy back so that he can go into the latter and get these tiles up and running for us. That will definitely help our city out. In fact, it's probably using the wrong tile right now, but we'll check once I've rolled back around. This scout has now just found our city. So that means that any units that come out of this barbarian hut from now on know where our city is. See, what tail are you using? I'd rather you use the food tail. Thank you, and get the growth. Plus one production from fishing boats would also be rather reasonable, although on a Pangaea I feel you're not getting that maximum benefit from that. It's done. And we'll just go ahead and finish up this second fishing boat, and that will be our first builder spent. There's another goodie hut for us. We've had two great goodie huts so far. Let's hope that can continue. 40 gold, it's not the best, but I suppose every little helps. I also got us another Eureka there because we've improved two sea resources. Looks like we could have a nice city up here, definitely. Four pastures. At least the one wheat. I'm going to continue scouting around this area. Another bloody barbarian. Let's get ourselves a slinger. I want to try and get the kill with a slinger so that we can pop the boost to archery. There's our pantheon, so let's just go ahead, God of the Open Sky, that's what it's called, that's right. So we'll go ahead with that. We're not getting any benefits from it yet, but yeah, that'll be lovely for us. And we can start with our civics, right? So we've already improved three tiles, so we've got the boost for craftsmanship. That will give us these cards. That's actually quite good, and that's also quite good. Yeah, so we'll go with that. For now, we'll pick up the plus strength, and we don't need that. Quite often I would put that in at the start of the game till I can get my pantheon. But we're not going to need that because of that lovely relic we found, so we can just put that production one in straight away. It's going to be nice. Wondering if it's worth even trying to snag that with a scout with the spearman right next to us. Especially if it's already been damaged, it could probably just take us straight out of the game. So I think it's best that we avoid doing that until we can get the slinger over there to help us out. If that scout wants to go ahead and suicide itself against us, then that's fine, we're happy with that. We'll take that all day long. So, where are we sitting just now? Right, so we have this available, we need irrigation for that. Let me have a look, see here, we need to get pottery to get fruit irrigation, we also need to farm a resource to get the boost for it. We have no resources to be farmed other than this wheat here, so chances are we're not going to be able to get the boost. What else do we have available? We could find out where the iron is, that's going to be good for us. We could get our pastures available, but we don't need that right now. We don't actually have any cities with any pastures in them yet. I think it would be quite good to, if we're going for a religion game, which frankly quite often I don't see too much need to change it in this game, but if you are going for a religion, you want to try and get your holy sites out quickly, especially as Australia. Let me see my appeal tiles here. There's a charming right there, so that would have been a great tile for the initial holy site to go down on. Getting that plus 3 bonus that we talked about with the unique trait. Anyway, let's go ahead. We'll just get pottery out of the way so that we can get through irrigation when we need it. And he did, in fact, go ahead and suicide. Brilliant. Let's get our scout healing up. Well, giving us vision out towards a barbarian camp to see if anything was coming after us. You can unlock these in, these are pretty solid tiles. We do want a galley or two, although I don't think I'm too worried about it right now. We could go ahead and fire out an early settler, that's always strong. We could get the builder, or we could leave that for a little while. In fact, if we started just now, we'd be able to put the 30% on next turn. We'd be able to get the builder out in a couple of turns. Allow us to hook up the luxury. Maybe get a couple of mines for production. I actually think I'm going to go with another slinger faster, actually. Since we've got the two camps nearby us, as I was saying as well, I just remembered that this one's going to have the horses. We want that dealt with. We'll keep the bonus against barbarians, since we're going to be fighting quite a few of them. We'll keep the bonus to all production, because if we put that in just now, we're going to be locked in on it for the next while, at least 10 turns, until we can change it for free. Yep, actually we're fine as it is. That gives us the bonus to naval units. Yeah, it's the one I like to go for. I should probably hold this guy off until he's got his pal able to go over with him and help him out. But I'll just edge him closer so that he can at least scout out the area. Right. At this point, I feel relatively comfortable building a settler and moving them over this way to settle a second city, since we're going to have these units over here to cover them anyway. So, let's go ahead and try and get him out nice and quickly. Let's find where the iron is. That's nice, that's 10 tons and 10 tons. We will be see if there's any iron over here by the time our settler's finished. Hopefully allowing us to pick some of that up. There, that's a nice defensive tile. Another change from Civ 5 you may not just have noticed is that normally your city would now be able to bombard him because he's within two tiles. Your cities don't automatically get the ability to bombard until they have walls in them. So what that means is that you need to wait until you have researched masonry and built the wall. And then getting stronger walls in your city throughout the researching other techs later on, you get better bombardment strength and such. And there's the horses that we were talking about. This wee guy is probably dead, frankly. I think we actually might need more friggin' units already. That's good, they split their attacks up. That was very fortunate. Let's kill the fucking horse and let's run you away. Just went back home. That's nice. That allows us to rest up if we need to. Let's go ahead and pick this as the promotion tree now. This is different as well. It allows you to see, you know, you don't need to, you can see some of them are linked, some of them aren't, so you can sort of follow the way the tree allows you to go. You can't promote and move in the same turn. Using your promotion uses all the remainder of your movement points for that unit. In fact, you know what? Fuck it, I'm going to sneak over here and get that hut that's irritating me that I haven't picked it up yet. Just hope it doesn't sacrifice our scout in the process. Don't want to leave ourselves on the marsh, since you take extra damage when you're standing in it. So we got our slinger kilt. What that got us was the Eureka for archery, which is right here. And you can see that it's halfway through now. 25th. Not wonderful, to be honest. If we hadn't picked up that relic earlier, it would have been quite a good goody hut. Quite a useful one, but ah well. Can't win them all. Now, another change is the fact that I'm acquiring a decent amount of faith per turn just now doesn't actually help me to found a religion. What you need are great profit points. You can't just, well, you can, but I would require 750 faith before I could buy a great profit, which is a lot. If I was wanting to go for a great profit to form my religion, I would have had to have gotten access to holy sites that I was talking about from the astrology tech. So here we are, ready to pick up our next civic. If we grow a city to size 6, we can get the Eureka for that, which is a nice one, but I don't think that'll happen for a while. Yeah, it's 21 turns before we're even size 5. There's not a lot of food available in this city. Frankly, I'll probably end up needing the granary, even just for the plus 1, it's still going to be nice. Also, building the settler's going to take one off of that, so it's going to be ages until we can proc that Eureka. So we'll just leave it for a wee bit just now. Should be able to clear an outpost relatively soon. What does that give us access to? Faster that. We're going to have the horse and the horse. But we're not going to be building any of them for ages either. Just going to go halfway through with that, I think. And then see if there's anything I want to change for the moment. Plus 2 to trade routes is nice later on, but obviously that's useless just now. I think what we've got still is going to be what's best for us. Also, we don't have to wait too long before we can change them again. So let's skip you away again. And in fact, I'm going to stop just scouting out that hut, I think, and I'm going to go exploring again. Need to know more about my surroundings. Sam got his promotion available, that's nice. There's more fucking mounted units. Exactly what I was talking about, why we need to take care of it nice and quickly. Let's get do your promotion, and I may just pull you back, see if you can come across this river at us. What kind of damage am I looking at doing to him? Quite a lot, actually. and that unit can't get to me to hit me, he should be safe. I don't really like it. Let's be bold. Should be fine. Right. Now, it's recommending I settled over in this direction. That's fine, because that's what I was thinking anyway. What I want to have a look at is the appeal tiles. Have a breathtaking there. Another breathtaking. I could pick up quite a few breathtaking tiles by settling over here. That'll be lovely for my district. Yep. Definitely looks like where I'm wanting to settle. We'll pick the exact spot once we get over that. Now, what do we want? Get a trader up, so that once we get a city, he can start sending a trade route back. Get another builder, so we could start firing out our luxuries. I think that sounds quite nice. Let's get animal husbandry as well, because we're going to finally actually have access to pastures. Yeah, we did just about survive that. We found a second continent, although we didn't get the Eureka from that, because we've already researched the tech. Right here is probably where I'm going to settle. Barbarian's Approach. I'm thinking there's probably another hut down here. Seems like it. Lots of flat land over here. Let's get you dead. Don't really... leaving you there, you are open to potentially getting killed. So I'll pull you back rather than start resting you. 1, 2, 3, yeah, we'll pick up the mercury and the wine from this city, that's nice. And we've just met someone. Gives us our Eureka for a rating. Nice to meet you. Sumeria being our closest neighbour is a bit shit, to be honest. He's very early game aggressive, usually. That's alright. Now that we know we pretty much don't have a choice in the matter, we're going to have early wars. And we've cleared the hut. Guess there's another Eureka. Next one. We're off to a reasonable start here. I just noticed there's another luxury up here. And another city, which will allow us more of these pastures as well. So, happy days. I'm actually going to go ahead and send him a delegation, see if we can be friendly with him for a wee while. Although we know there's going to be early war, it doesn't mean we want it to be super duper early. Yeah, city state. Nice one. We would love to meet another two of them. Pop the inspiration for political something or other. That political philosophy. That's the one. We might hang on to that envoy. Your apostle units can choose for any possible promotion. I'm not bothered about that since I'm not chasing religions. Gonna hang on to that envoy. Wonders and conscription is actually a really good one. I'll do this once since I've got that boost for it. Pick that up, we've got a little bit more gold. Met another city state, nice, nice. What does Jerusalem offer us? Ah, that's right, it works as a sort of holy site for pushing out your religion. Again, I'm not bothered with that. Maybe I should change my plans and actually start a religion game. Should I move over closer to this natural wonder? Let me just quickly check the appeal tiles again. 1, 2, 3, yeah, we're reaching that. We've got quite a few charmings. It's not as good as the breathtaking, but still helps. You know, yeah, I'm just gonna settle there. Right, so what's this city called? Adelaide. Can't think of any funny words that are similar to Adelaide, so I'm not gonna bother changing that one. Toss out the monument. In fact, are we gonna need the monument in here? Yeah, because it'll get us to these pastures, which are then gonna fire our border straight out. It's gonna be excellent. You can go ahead and rest up now that you're in the city and safe. So this ivory down here looks like it's not the best city spot, although I've settled worse. I'll continue scouting around about it. Actually, I think I'm moving towards that even though I don't have irrigation yet. It's a bit stupid. Let's get ourselves access to archers. The upgrade from slingers to archers is a relatively cheap one, and it makes your units significantly better. Let's get that trader going. Help our cities develop, or in fact, we probably do have a close enough. He wants a heavy chariot, he wants a campus. I figured maybe one of them would have wanted to trade route, I just sent them it. Get the extra envoy. Yep. I'm a Wally. let's put him in there, we can improve that tile. Move you over here, see what other stuff we have. See, it's not too bad. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, he has access to that pasture himself, so I'd probably leave that for the capital, but there's another 3. With a deer, some minerals, it's possibly another ivory depending on where I settled. It's not the worst city spot in the world. We could settle there for the housing, still get that ivory as well, get... We'd miss out on the deer, although that's not too bad. Yeah, I'd be relatively happy with that. We'd also pick up this other horse. Jesus. Drop you in the water, it's just safe that way. If we build that trade unit, it's probably just going to get plundered anyway, so... Start off on another slinger, which will upgrade into an archer, that'll be nice. We'll also pull you back. Sometimes you find this in Civ 6, you just get really hemmed in by bobs. Especially when you have a fucking horses. Let's make sure we're using that tail as well. We are, it's nice. One thing Barbs seem less happy to do is just pillage all your tiles. Normally that would have been pillaged by now in Civ 5. I'm not saying they're not going to pillage it, I'm just saying they seem a bit slower about it. Right, you go ahead and knock him out. Could pull you back as well. Although I quite like the idea of leaving you over there for a bit of safety and a bit of extra scouting in that direction. Next place I probably want to scout is up in here. Although that looks like a lot of rainforests, I'm not that bothered by rainforests. Some fairly weak tiles. There's certain civs that get boosts to them. I think it's Brazil. They get an adjacency bonus for their districts from rainforests. And that's about the only time I think they're useful. Yeah, fine, let's start working on Early Empire. May jump off it when we're halfway through. In fact, we're going to get the boost to that in 3 turns. That's going to be lovely. Start sketching you back home. We can upgrade you once you get there. And you can start helping to deal with all these little mob eggs. Fish would be a reasonably nice tail for us as well. We don't want to waste 100 quid on it right now, I don't think. Okay, and you never swapped that rune. You're probably... where are my bottles going? Up that way? Nap. You're probably as well just heading out in the city just now and keep yourself safe. And there's that tail pillaged. You could just put yourself to sleep some. Even though your city's being sieged, you feel comfortable just taking a wee nap. And the balls are still. It's good writing that will allow us to get campus and get our great scientist points rolling. Fuck off, I'm not going to be able to get you back and upgraded. Fine. Pain in the ass. Right, fine. I'll take you back now. That looks like a pretty nice tail to me. Let's get you straight into the city, keep you safe. I'll upgrade both of you next turn. Somebody's built Stonehenge, so that's them got a religion. How are religions going in general? There's only one of 5, so that's the only one that's out there right now. Great people. He's working on one, he's working on one. So, Gilgamesh will end up with a religion. Probably just give us his, so I'm alright with that, to be honest. Hopefully he gives us something reasonably decent. Upgrade and upgrade. 60 gold well spent. That's going to be a stonker of a harbour adjacent to the 3 sea resources and adjacent to the city centre. Right, here we go. Let's start taking some shots at these buggers. No, not going to the city. Shoot the horse in the face. Him dead already. As I was saying, the upgrade from slingers to axles is really quite significant. Even if just for the extra point of range. Right, so you can start scooching forward. You're going to help out. I'm going to start resting. I'm going to have a look-see at what I want overall. Definitely want that irrigation. Even though it's not boosted, I think it's going to be worthwhile. We need to start getting some luxuries up and rolling. Although we don't actually have any luxury requirements yet. Although that's probably even more of a reason to actually get some rolling. It means we make our cities happy and getting the bonuses. We might just get plundered if I send you just now. So I'm actually going to hold off a turn or two till I get that horsey dead. And yes, I just said horsey. I'm not childish. Do we want? We want more settlers, that's for damn sure. Gonna be popping early empire next time anyway. Yep, yep. That's gonna be fine and dandy. Maybe I should just start swimming you over there just now. Yep, yep, yep. Right, so where are we sending you? Do we want the gold and the faith? Or do we want to help out our city? The free gold a bit is a bit negligible, to be honest, I think. And our capital's growth is a bit shit, as I've said, so yeah, let's help them out. Right, give us some of that. And I actually think we'll probably start building the naval units soon. Nah, I'll leave it as it is because we're still fighting a lot of barbs. Let's get state workforce. Continue scouting up here. To buy a scout. I'd really like to have scouted more than this early game. Ah, fuck off. They are barbarian hussies. This game doesn't like me today. What do we want? What do we want? To toss out a nice campus already. Put you there, you'll be adjacent to... Nah, it's going to be a better spot for a thingy, community. Not commercial hub, community hub. That's a pretty useless shit tail. So that'd be good to put our campus on. Taking a wee while to get that produced, but these tiles will be getting improved soon, so that'll help with that. Oh, for fuck's sake. Shoot it. Well done. We've met the Chinese. Chinese are... Every time I've had China in a game, they've been pretty fine. They've never been too dangerous. They've never been too unfriendly. suppose hostile would have been a better word. Right. Start sending you up into here. So I can see what's up that way. You'll be pairing up with this little guy. Going up after these evil barbarians. Leave me alone. Can easily outrun him just now because I've got that movement bonus in hills. So I'm not at danger from that horse. Also need that repaired. Schnessing, that's working away so early. I need just buy myself one. Improve that tail. Maybe farm that. And then save his third boost. His third action for the third city I'm about to settle. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Give me a walker, please. Thank you. Find some silver up here. No bad city location. We're starting to get a wee bit far away. But, don't know. It doesn't seem like there's anybody up there that would hinder that progress. We'll see where it suggests we should put that next settler before we go ahead and choose. Quite often you end up disagreeing with it, but got a turnout on that, it's fine, we'll just wait. Right, you go and repair that. Now, as you can see, repairing an improvement doesn't use one of your charges. So quite often it's good to just have a worker with one charge left sitting in your empire. Especially if you're at war and you're going to be getting stuff pillaged. You can just go around and repair everything indefinitely. That's where China is. Cool. They've got an extra charge on their builders, as you can see. Don't know why he's got a builder away out there anyway. Slightly tempted to steal it, if I'm honest. If it was a settler, I wouldn't even be hesitating. I'd just do it. Right, you jump over there and get our first amenity on the rope. Right, so it's suggesting over here. Does look reasonable. We know we can pick up that extra amenity in here. But as I was saying, the rainforests are a bit lackluster. But it will get us these extra pastures for the couple of points of culture and such. So it's not stupid. This is going to have... there's jade there as well. You can pick up two luxuries from settling over here. We're still getting more tobacco as well. Getting a pasture. Oh yeah, we definitely want to set it over there. Somewhere or other. Send you there just now and then we'll pick the exact spot. Can't remember where the barbarian hut actually is. I think I can set a lens for it. Barbarian. There he's there. We've got the boost to currency, which means we can get markets. It's actually going to be reasonable. Yep, yep, Hanging Gardens isn't bad. I don't really fancy chasing wonders too much. As you can see, it's just a 15% growth rate in every city. I'll go ahead and click on it though, just to show what wonders, how wonders work in this. What you actually have to do is choose a tile to put your wonder on, and it consumes that tile. So you want to ideally be putting them on tiles that you won't want to work in your city. The problem with that is obviously they've got specifics, like it has to be adjacent to a river. So you can't just decide, oh, this is a crappy tile, way out here in the middle of nowhere, I'll put it there. We'll get our campus in here as well. We don't seem to have any breathtaking tiles. It's not very nice. Let's have a look at that. Actually, am I going to have any within its radius at all? Not the only one is that. Actually might kill that tobacco to get a breathtaking tile. Or would it remain breathtaking after taking it, after taking the tobacco off it? I'm not entirely sure. I think it would, because we'd still have the tobacco anyway, and we're going to end up with excess of it. It's not entirely out of the realms to harvest it. I think I'm actually going to. Right, you. You don't have your turn yet. Right, I'll spend you a turn wasting building something else. Right, you can start a galley. And then next turn, butcher that. If I have the tech, I think I do. Let's jump down and make check straight away. Right. We don't have the tech to be able to remove that feature, which is a frigging pain. Don't want to just waste it. Let's have a look. Does this tell us what we need? No. Harvest. Nope. Builder. Right, I think this will show me all the build directions. Somewhere. Farms, minions, quarries, blah blah blah. Nope, that just shows us all the tiles. That's annoying. Maybe you just outright can't harvest it. Right. Not a problem. You actually can't put a campus on it at all. You don't have the option to put a campus on top of a luxury. Right. Seems like something I should have known. So we definitely want it adjacent to this mountain then. Which could then end up being adjacent to a commercial hub maybe. We like getting our campuses out early, like to get science points rolling. Science is good. Yeah, as you can see, all that did to that was give it an additional 1 gold. So, I mean, it's a crappy tile. It's not. It's still just a 2 food. No production. Yeah, tobacco's crap. We've got our wine on the go. Wine is nice. On the other hand, it's at least got a point of production. And it's got extra gold. The thing with the tobacco is that it gives you faith, and not a lot of tiles give you access to a faith yield. I suppose it is good if you're going for that type of game. You want to jump off of that galley, your wally, which we can't do just now because we're between turns. I always try to do that. Right, move. Fine, just cancel it. And let's use our first lovely little culture bomb. That was nice. Gets us access to a good deer tail there, which would actually allow us to grow faster than using that. So, yep, we'll go ahead and leave ourselves where we are. Jump you up on the hill. You're the same. Yeah, you just can both shoot that now. That'll be dead in no time. This tail's done now. We could farm that. Though we don't really want to. We're probably going to end up with a commercial hub there. What would they want today? Stick a camp on that deer. Another little point of gold, I think. Shite. Fuck off, little horse. And we met the third city state that we were hoping to meet. Amsterdam. Amsterdam's actually relatively useful, I think. The trade routes to foreign cities gain extra gold for each luxury resource at the destination. Well, it's better than any of the religious ones we've found so far. So, we'll toss an invite at him. Yeah, we definitely, we don't seem to need that plus strength against barbs anymore. Archers are more than ample for taking care of those. What two amenities do we have? Why do we have two? That's just a bonus. That's a luxury. Oh, I win. Right, so he's got three though. One from entertainment. If you say so. I'm not entirely down on how all of it works. So the other thing I did say about when I settled this is whether it would get the coastal bonus and the river bonus for housing, and it seems that it does since it's already got 11 housing, which is awesome. You've only got 9, but you don't have the palace the capital has. So yeah, it's good to know. It's definitely good to know. Pick our civic. Aye, we definitely want that. Although there's a better government. Although there's more policy cards. Just met Zanzibar apparently. They have a Caesarian, unfortunately. That's one of the better ones. Especially if you're in a low amenities game. We need to try and steal them away from China though. Let me just auto scout him. Ah, we've got this little sheep available now. That's good. We'll culture bomb that. Yeah, auto scout. You know what I'm doing? Sometimes the buttons for this game, the hotkeys and the keyboard just decide they don't want to fucking do anything. So if you settle there, we'll get loads of shit. good initial yields as well. Aye, you can go there. Seems we've still got a decent amount of land round about us though. We just realised we've crept over the hour mark for this video. I like to keep my sub videos at an hour. So I'm going to put a cut in here. And then I'm not stopping though. I'm going to just continue straight on with another video. So thanks for tuning in. This Civ 6 file will be being played to a conclusion. I'm going to try and make Monday my Civ upload date. So if you're enjoying the series and want to try and watch me improve my gameplay, because I know I'm not the best Civ 6 player yet, then please tune in for more videos. They should be going up every Monday.